Hey everybody, what's going on? Back for another video again, thanking the Most High for so much, giving him all the honor, the glory, and all the praise, man. I want to talk to, young people in this video. Or gifted people, to the young and the gifted. To the young and gifted. I just want to say, man, watch out for temptations in this world, you know what I mean? Especially those of you who really have a gift. Like, people know about it, watch out for temptation, man, because, there's a whole lot of pitfalls. There's a whole lot of things out here for you that you can get caught up in, especially when you really got a gift and people want to maybe exploit it, and it might be in the wrong type of way, just be careful. Some of you probably have a singing talent. Some of you might have a speaking talent. Some of you a spiritual talent. Many of you have, different types of gifts or something, that you can use in a positive way. Just watch out, man. There's a whole lot of stuff in here in the world for you, man, to get caught up in. Different stuff out here, temptations and stuff that can really rob you of your potential and what you, I'm just saying, watch out for, because you know how many people, they had a great singing voice and then they got hooked on maybe drugs or something, and now their voice ain't as good as it was. I got hooked in many things, man. And this is what you need to know, man. The devil is after. He is really after people who are gifted, either who are really gifted or have the potential to be great. He's looking for these type of people because he wants to do everything he can to stop you from influencing this world in a positive way. So he puts all this stuff in you, in your face. He tries to, he tries to bring you down. So you basically can't use it, but the devil is a lie, I think of Samson Delilah in the Bible. He had, he had supernatural strength. That was his gift, the Holy Spirit came on him when the time was needed. He was, couldn't nobody stop him. That was his gift. God gave him supernatural strength to protect Israel from their enemies, from his enemies, especially from the Philistines, who was, at that time, helped come up against them. And he was extremely gifted, man, he had a, how can I say it, a temptation of the war women that he couldn't control, you know, all of us men, you know, guys and men, you know, that's our weakness. You know, that's one of our big weaknesses, you know. No, no offense to women, but, you know, that's, I mean, when it comes to y'all, y'all are one of our biggest weaknesses, and, you know, especially, it wasn't the fact that he wanted women that was strange, that was, you know, he didn't want none of the Hebrew, he wanted one of the Philistine women, and that was his weakness toward, you know, untrustworthy women who ultimately ended up using them, who ended up betraying him. You know, the first time he got betrayed, because he was going to get married, and they conspired to basically gave him to, I ain't gonna go over the whole thing, but they basically, you know, there was this riddle that he gave them to solve, and they couldn't solve it, so they told his wife, which was a Philistine woman, to beg to get it out of him. And then she would tell them, and she was able to get it out of him. And she told them, and they answered it. And of course, he got mad. But the whole thing was, and then we all know, if y'all know the situation with Delilah, you know, the same thing happened where she begged him, and he told her, and then, you know, but that was his weakness. The ultimate ended up, you know, being his downfall, man. He accomplished many great feats. You know, he killed, you know, 1,000 Philistines. When they found out, he got really angry. He was really mad, and the Holy Spirit came on him, and he slew 30 men because he owed them guys. He said, "I'll give you 30. I'll pay each of you a garment." And so he had to go get the garments from somewhere, and he slew 30 men and paid them. You know, he tied the foxes but everything like that. And we know about the, you know, he killed the lion with his bare hands, and the lion attacked him, and he accomplished many great feats, man. But ultimately, his temptation was what, you know, he couldn't really control, and it led to his downfall. Because, you know, they knew what his weakness was. They knew, you know. That's the thing. Satan knows our weaknesses, man. Maybe you don't know this, but over the ages, he has studied mankind and the things that make us, if we can be vulnerable to and susceptible and really to fall prey to, you know, he knows about that. And ultimately, you know, he wants to use that against you, you know, to keep you from, you know, being all you can. You know what I mean? That's all I'm saying, man. Just watch out for temptations in this world, because there's a whole lot. There's a lot of stuff. Especially when you're gifted. When you're gifted, people, you know, tend to, if you're gifted, the enemy really wants, you know, to bring you down, because, you know, you can influence people in both in a positive way, in a way that can benefit others, that's what he wants, man. So if you have, this is all the gifted people, you know, beware, you know, watch out, you know, watch out for certain things, man. as I said, I don't struggle because I struggle a lot with certain things, you know, I mean, we're in this flesh, you know what I mean? But I try to, you know, stay focused, you know what I mean? And, yeah. You know, if you read the Bible, man, so many men, especially, you know, fell prey. It was behind a woman. You know, like I said, no offense to women, but yeah, it's true. You know, with David, it was Bathsheba. With Solomon, it was this 700 wives and 300 concubines. And with Samson, it was Delilah, you know. Many of us got something, you know, many of us got a weakness, you know, that yeah. But, no, many of us got something that we might be vulnerable to. If it was presented in front of us, you know, we would struggle. But I just want y'all to know that with the Holy Spirit on your side, man, you can overcome anything, man. And if you got God in your life, he will help you, you know, to deal with these certain situations, if you let him, you know, if you just let him in, you know. So, yeah, man, so that ain't going to make it, you know, but to the gifted people, man, just as I say, you know, be strong, use your gift in a positive way, man, that can really, just watch out, man. Watch out for pitfalls and stuff. Because many, many great people, many people in general have failed behind, you know, especially people of faith, you know, have failed behind a certain, you know, temptation or a certain, a certain weakness. You know what I mean? Many people in general have failed due to a certain thing that they just could not, you know, kill or get rid of, or, you know, they couldn't get it under control, and it ultimately ended up, you know, destroying them. That's all I'm saying, man. Be cautious. Be vigilant, you know. Because, you know, there's stuff out here. We know it's out there, you know. I mean, the enemy knows, you know, like I said, but you don't have to let it. You can overcome with anything, with the Most High on your side, you know. Once you get connected with him, he'll break everything in your life, you know, if you just trust him, and if you just, you know, if you really want to do the right thing, you know. And you might mess up, you know, you might fall, you might miss tomorrow, but that doesn't mean it's the end, you know. If you mess up, get back up and learn from it. Many of us have, you know, fail due to a certain weakness, you know, I fail. But the whole thing is, you know, it's not, like I said, it's not the end of the race. It's not the end of, you know, just get back up, learn from it and move on, man. God will forgive you. The whole thing is, have you learned something from it? So when it comes the next time, you know, you won't fall for the same thing again, you know. That's what it's about, man. And Samson, once he realized his mistake, you know, once they realized, they got it right. Based on, long story short, but you know, once again, if you miss the mark, you fall, get back up and keep going, you know. Don't let your mistake paralyze you, and because that's exactly what the enemy wants. You know, he wants you to think that God don't love you. That's what he puts in your head, that God don't love you no more. That, oh man, you know. But that's just a lie he puts in your head to keep you in a crippling state. But the whole thing is, man, once you get up, you know, try to, learn from it. Learn from what you did wrong that way. And then, you know, just ask yourself what happened that led to this point, you know. So that way you can, when it comes up, should it ever come up the next time, you know. You know what I mean? You know now, so it won't, it can't get you. There's stuff out here for you, I'm just telling you, especially for gifted people. So I'm just telling you, be careful out here in this world, you know. Be careful. I'm talking to gifted people, young people, gifted people in general, you know, who are up and coming, you know. Just be careful. Be very careful, because like I said, you're bound to fall anytime. So, yeah, man. That being said, you know, I hope everybody is doing well. Hope you're having a nice day. You know, yeah. Be safe. Be safe. So, that being said, peace. Remain blessed.